Obstructive sleep apnea is an entity where children stop breathing when they sleep, and they'll have periods of obstruction, not just mild snoring, but they are snoring, stopping breathing, and then gasping. And their sleep may become motion-filled, where they flop around, they seek a position where they're not obstructing. Obstructive sleep apnea in children can lead to hyperactivity, attention deficit disorder. At its worst extreme, it can even lead to right-sided heart failure. Children retain fluid. It's also been shown to impact how they learn. There are neurocognitive impacts to having obstructive sleep apnea. If you don't sleep well at night, you don't have your brain refreshed. When they come to see me, the clinical history may be so compelling that we don't need to do a sleep study. And consequently, we will go ahead and fix what the problem is with the child. Many times we'll send a child for a sleep study where they'll spend the night in a lab and learn how much obstruction they have, whether or not they have heart arrhythmias or any other things like that. A tonsillectomy and an adenoidectomy often are curatives for sleep apnea in children. We typically will see the child back after surgical intervention to make sure that everything is resolved, and it's very effective for most of the children.